Morning everyone, we're live down here at the Murray River Tea Rooms. We've got our head barista and Premier League star, Glenn Rogers. Welcome everyone, we're just going to go through a review and thought we'd bring you somewhere different, something new that's in town, which is pretty close to my heart. I'm an ambassador for the Open Doors Project, which is linked in with the Murray River Tea Room. So welcome Glenn, or Rocket as I know you.
Thanks Steve.
How's it all going?
Yeah, no, it's exceeded all expectations the last couple of weeks, so we're delighted with how everything's going, and the clients are all getting involved, and it's fantastic for the community.
Yeah, I've heard you've had to recruit in. You've been pretty busy from all reports, so that's great. Great that community supporting such a great venture. And over to the Premier League, and your boys are starting to get rolling.
Yeah, we hit a bit of a hurdle last week, but we were playing the Dimple Balls. But
they're the standout team, and they come with a bit of history, obviously, with their performance in finals. So we won't find out a lot about them until they get there. But you know, all you can do is win, and that's what they're doing. So
we're just clinging on for dear life in the eight at the moment. But we're hoping
16,
to.
There's a big bunch in the middle there, isn't there?
And as I say, we've got an 8-point game this week, so
against, I think we've got mixed bag, I think,
this week.
So
it's a very important round. So
over to last week's matches, and I couldn't find any other teammates. They're all in hiding this week after our team succumbed after the brilliance of the week before, succumbed to the hybrids for their first win of the year, and it was from winning with only four players on the field to then going down to the team that hasn't won a match yet. Was a bit embarrassing, but anyway, well done to Kim Richardson from the hybrids with 38 points, Lane Brule 33, and Roman Lewandowski with 33, too good for us. Ben Patton, the only shining light, with 34, and then I was next best with 30. Joel Watson with 29, so those sort of scores in your top four, you're just never going to.
Yeah, Kim Richardson seems to be pretty consistent, so
he
might be a smoky for the Brownlow.
Well, he's already won one, so, and he's an enigma to me because he gets great pleasure out of giving me a hard time. No doubt he'll be doing the same this week. Caddy Pax got the win over the bye, or Caddy Shack or something.
They just scraped home there, I see.
Two points. Well, that's standard apparently, the way the system works.
Yeah.
Hackers versus Chubbs Peterson, a really close one, this one. And Hackers just getting the job done. Dave Pearson with 35. Jeff Ridge, 33. John Clancy, 32. Hanny in there with 33 as well. Chubbs, Paul Allen started with 38, but then they struggled the rest of the boys. So.
Yeah, Paul Allen's. You know, chipped in a couple of times this year with a couple of rounds.
Another one,
so.
And your boys, Dimple Balls, Steve McComb with 38, Craig Healy 34, Stu Mansell 33, and Rob Kilgour 31, just getting it done.
Yeah, we needed sort of a 38 or a 39 there to sort of lift us, but no one sort of. Nick Rapitalis has been playing well the last couple of weeks, so.
We've been playing a lot of golf in Shep, so that's going to help him.
And I must point out to Snags, Craig Healy, congratulations on winning the match play championship too, so that's a good effort. I think he was three down with four to play against Dave Pearson, so. We went to the 21st hole or something, I think, so he's done well to get up there. So.
I'm sure Snags would know that wouldn't be his forte coming back from the death. He's normally the one who finds a way to talk himself out of it. So
yeah, that's right.
Well done, Snags. And mentioned Sean Slattery there, 30 points, doesn't sound a lot, but coming back from long-term injury, he's slowly finding his way back, so it's good to see, and might be a smoky come finals. Against the grain, solid win against Hump Day. Travis Clack and Tim Leake, 37 apiece, that's really good score.
Maybe they must have set the pin position.
They did. It was pretty tough out there. It was very
tough. They had sort of insider knowledge trading. Exactly, yeah.
When you consider they've won with the 24 points to Jelly League's Brad Mason.
I had the, I won't say privilege of playing with Brad, but...
It's unique. Everyone's got their own style. Brad's got his, and good on him.
Yeah.
And not much to say for Hump Day. They had a great win the week before, but really struggled, like a lot of teams did last week. Lady Boys, our next match, and Mixed Bag. A Mixed Bag, good solid win. The captain let his clubs do the talking. Steve Morgan with 38 points.
Captain Morgan.
Peter Goff, no shanks this week, and 32, and Terry Cargill and Kane Anderson, 31. If you got four scores over 30 last week, you actually did pretty well.
So,
I did nicely. Not much to mention for Lady Boys there. Morell Lake with 34, and that was it, really. Then the ladies actually kept them up. The next three scores are all ladies in their team. So a bit of work to do there. And the last match, Grandads versus Reluctant Heroes. And Reluctant Heroes reluctantly speak this team up because they've been sledging a bit lately, not everyone. But a good effort. Jade Bennett, 38.
Yeah, Jade back to form. You know, it's been a long time between drinks, I think, for Jade. So the handicap's been slipping out a bit, but it's nice to see him have good ground.
Good ball striking when he's up and going. So.
And Kirk, pretty solid, 33. So.
For the granddads, Jaden Dixon, been solid all season, and he'd be another smoky for the Brownlow, I would think. Barry Bintang, Mark Langenbacher, 33, and Guy Galvin in there with 30 points. So, pretty close match, really. 6 points is, that's just Terry Jeffries turning around a bit, and they get the win. So, pretty good round. Not much to report because we were in hiding basically after our defeat. Rich and Ben, I think, have been away 2 days this week just trying to avoid the spotlight as much as possible. So there is talk in our team that because Richard didn't play the start of the week before, we just can't get it done without him. So we don't have any of that sort of feedback coming from our team and our unit, and we can win in any situation normally. Round 9, so next week, Hybrids versus Caddyshackers. I'm probably tipping the Caddyshackers there.
I'm hoping the Hybrids can get up with that little side wager I've got with Chad Jones, and we're 8th on the ladder now, and I think they're 6th or 7th, so I'm sort of hoping the Hybrids can come to the fore.
Chubbs versus Weapons of Grass Destruction, and there's a big match. Both similar spots on the ladder now. We're just one game ahead, but with the lowest percentage, we could find ourselves out of the 8 this week if we drop this match. So it's a massive game.
Hopefully, Dick's back on board, and you're
gonna
be a spiritual leader now.
Going to be wet too, so I don't do rain either. Going to be a challenge. Dimple Balls get a rest this week. Hackers versus Hump Day. I think Hackers too good in that one. Thoughts?
Hackers, I think,
They've been pretty solid. Your mob against Mixed Bag?
Yeah, I need to sort of probably step up a bit this week, and I'm hoping, after Sean being sort of lightly run, that he's got
his pack
back sort of thing. So, and as I say, Nick's been playing well, so... Tiro out there to Pete Whitcorn, who's just had a back operation, so we've won down for the rest of the year. So
that'll make this picture even sweeter if it comes about. But the Mixed Bag boys, they're a bit of a hard team to get hold of, and when they get going, they can do some damage. So I probably can't pick one there. I'd probably ease towards your team, but you've got your work cut out.
Yes, we have.
Against the Grain and Reluctant Heroes. Well, Reluctant Heroes, I think, should get the job done there. Against the Grain, just struggled with numbers. Got their 8 on the park each week, they'd be a bit more dangerous. And Lady Boys versus Grandads. Probably Grandads, I think, have been pretty solid all year. Lady Boys,
In saying that, the Lady Boys are, they're in the eight, so
they're sitting there okay. So yeah, be an interesting round. It'll probably start to sort the finals out a little bit. This one, I think, some key matches right across the park. Last thing I wanted to talk to you about was we've got our golf day coming up, the Jono's Run next week, the par 3 event. Just a bit of a plug for that. Your partner?
Brendan Kelly. So we don't see Kelly a bit now, but much lately, so it'd be nice to get him out on the links. So,
Busy stacking his minions away, I think. Working pretty hard building a house, I think, as well trying to keep a business going, so that'll be good. But yeah, format of the day, every hole's going to be a par 3. We'll have a prize value $150 and upwards on every hole, plus our first, second and third for the day. Something unique, something that's never been done before, and something we've talked about for a long time as members. So if you're thinking about it, it's open to everyone. It's not just for people with handicaps or supposedly good players. So
yeah, and I just want to stress that, you know, like, I've been very fortunate in my life, and Steve, you've been the same, so this is a great cause, you know, so for those people who are, you know, a bit less fortunate than ourselves, so it's get behind it, you know.
Absolutely. Something that's, I just think...
And it's unique, it's a bit of fun. And
we've never done it before. I'm really one, because I'm always a bit of a one-shot wonder, so hit that one good shot and I might win a prize. So.
Exactly, and that's how I'm sort of... That's why my dollar goes into super in most weeks.
So yeah, if you'd like to get behind our Jono's Run team, just call the pro shop for our golf day, 5481 3372, or get onto the club's website. There's an entry form on there, or you can call into the Murray River Tea Rooms here. They also have entry forms.
And why are you here? Toasted sandwiches or a cake or what have you.
An awesome environment in here. Sit back and watch the world go by.
Oh, and we've got Wi-Fi in that as well. So
I did notice that.
Yeah.
Straight in.
Yeah. So.
Thanks very much, Rob. It's been
no worries, Steve.
A lot
Thank
of fun.
You.
It's good to see what you're doing day to day. It's interesting to get outside the four walls of the golf club sometimes and see what's going on. So thanks very much.
No worries, mate. Good on you.